just wanted to see a move of God. And Sister Tina, I don't know any individual that was on that very lengthy platform, boys and girls, I'm talking children, probably Kylie, your age. They were up there on the platform, and I had my eyes closed in worship, and I felt the presence of God. It was so strong in my dream as I was dreaming. Sister Rachel, my dream, I opened my eyes and I looked at that platform. And all across that platform, there were these young kids slain in the spirit, their hands raised, worshiping God, speaking in tongues. I don't know if it's because of what I was studying. I don't know why I dreamed the dream. I don't know, Brother David. I don't know what God wanted to do. But this I do know, that God wants to fill with the Holy Ghost. Every age. And God wants to move in lives. Listen, I want to see Pentecost. I don't want this just to be the Sunday, the 50th Sunday after Easter, so we celebrate Pentecost. David, I want to be an experience that changes my life. I have experienced Pentecost in a lot of ways in my life. But I don't want it to grow old or die. Pentecost isn't just a day to be celebrated. Pentecost is an experience through the Spirit of God. God's Spirit sending the Holy Ghost in us. Can I say something? If you're struggling in your life, if you say, "Oh, so God, I've given things to God. I'm struggling. I need to do some things in my life." I believe that if you let the Holy Ghost in this morning, amen, there'll be things in you and through you that you could never imagine. Sister Holly, if you come to the piano this morning, I'm not preaching a message on Pentecost just because it's Pentecost Sunday. I'm preaching a message on Pentecost because God wants us each have a Pentecost, an experience in the Holy Ghost. I don't believe that tongues are just for certain people. The gift of tongues is a gift. But the Word of God says that out of our belly shall flow rivers of living water. That's for every believer. God wants to fill you. It's not something that you need to initiate. Something that the Spirit of God does through you as you yield your vessel to Him. This morning, take what Brother Saville has said. Even if you're skeptical, you say, "Brother Saville, I don't know. I want you this morning to take what I said, line it up with the Word of God, find a place of prayer, and allow the Spirit of God to work and move through you. The Holy Ghost will change your life. It will empower you. With that said, I want folks to gather in. Amen. Let's be in one place. Let's be in one accord. Let's seek the Spirit of God, the Father in and among us this morning. Amen. Let's gather in. God filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. Come on, let's gather in, everybody. Amen. God, here on this Pentecost Sunday, fill me. Fill me. Fill me. If it's been a little while since you used, amen, the Holy Ghost or speaking in other tongues, I'm going to ask you, why don't you let the Holy Ghost just begin to pray through you and work through you this morning? It'll change your life. It'll change your situation. Amen. Oh, Spirit of God, work and move through us all around these altars. Let's seek the Holy Ghost this morning.